Bob Roberts, who is the candidate for sheriff.
I'm Judge Dan McCaffrey, and I'm here to ask you to support it. I'd like to start off before I get back to it in the meat and potatoes of why I'm running and about my background. Important to you guys, so people understand a little bit about my background. So I think who we are as children, who our families are, is really defines who becomes adults and defines the kind of character that we're going to be. At the end of the day, you take a look at my resume, you take a look at my highly recommended by the Bar Association, that really doesn't tell you a whole lot about it. So I start off by telling everybody a little bit about the family background. It's on all of my information. My mother and father come from a little town called Belfast.
My dad was so proud of himself, and when he told his mother and father, he was the oldest of 14. He was so proud of himself, and he talked to that, he proposed to my mother, he was 15. They were married, she was 15, he was 15. He turned professional, he became an all-Ireland champion, he ranked in Europe at that point. And he was 21 years old, he worked at this particular printing factory for 4 years, he was in the last year of his apprenticeship. On July 12th, my dad came back to his place of business, and his place was decorated. And it wasn't decorated with God's forgive, with Happy Birthday Seamus. It was decorated with Union Jacks and God Save the Queen. Now imagine for a second, you come back to your place of employment, you see swastikas hanging up in your place of employment. Or if you're African American, you come back and you see hoods or newspapers hanging in your place of employment. You would react pretty much the same way my dad reacted. My dad tore down this offensive material, he threw it in the trash can. He turned around and he was confronted by his four coworkers,
four guys that he had worked with every day for the last 4 or 5 years,
as he called friends and coworkers, and they promptly held my dad down and they beat him into a coma with a wooden mallet.
My dad woke up 30 days later.
He looked up at his employer and he was fired from his job for fighting. The four guys that beat him into a coma still had their job. My father was fired.
He looked at my mother. He looked at his three children, my sister, my wife, my brother Noel, my brother Seamus,
and he realized that in Ireland, Belfast, Northern Ireland, his children would not have the opportunities that he wanted to give them for education and for advancement. So my dad did what all of our ancestors did. He came to this country. My dad came on a boat. After 18 months, he had $56 in his pocket
with a briefcase.
He came to a country where he didn't know a single soul. He saved up enough money to bring my mother and three oldest children to this country. The rest of us were raised in the Philadelphia section of our city. My dad joined the Union Philadelphia, became a union organizer for the Printers Union, and my mother was given a job at the local school district as a training coach. She was still at work for 26 years and a proud member of SEIU. My father and mother came to this country looking for an opportunity, and America became the dream for them. Every single one of the children had a college degree, one went to the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, and the youngest myself as a judge, seeking a spot in the Superior Court of Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, my family literally is the American dream. And I look at people and I tell people that so you understand a little bit about my background. My father believed when he came to this country that this is our adopted country, we need to give back. I joined the United States Army, I took a little less travel in history. I didn't get out of college. I joined the United States Army and I served proudly 3 years after duty with the first battle of duty. This is my uniform, which I wear proudly wherever I go across the I served 3 years active duty as an air assault cavalry chief. After 3 years, I was one of 40 soldiers worldwide who selected to attend the United States Military Academy at West Point by the officer corps. I attended West Point Prep. I decided I did not want to make a career in the military. I was honorably discharged. I attended Temple University on a veteran scholarship and Temple Law School on a veteran scholarship. Graduated from Temple undergraduate in 2 years and I joined the Philadelphia District Attorney's Office as a prosecutor. That was a job that fit me like a glove. Anybody knows anything about the Philadelphia District Attorney's Office, it's one of the most crime-ridden areas in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, if not the most crime-ridden areas in Pennsylvania. I prosecuted in excess of thousands and thousands and thousands of cases in my 6 year career, 60 or 70 jury trials. I was one of the top prosecutors at Lynn Abraham's office. I became a prosecutor in the Mitchell Henry Unit, a major trial unit, and all the specially assigned cases. I left there in 1997 and I joined a small little law firm in Montgomery County for 4 years. We became one of the fastest growing law firms in Pennsylvania. I became a partner in 2 years. I became the chairman of the litigation department in 3 years. And I'm the managing partner of that firm for the last 2 years. But I gave that up because of public service. Public service is near and dear to my heart. In 2013, I was elected to the Philadelphia Court of Common Pleas. Since that time, I've presided over 250 jury trials. I've read about 300 opinions. That's when I've been overturned twice. One of my decisions actually was overturned by the Superior Court, reinstated from the Superior Court. But I tell everybody that, ladies and gentlemen, so you know a little bit about my background and why I'm running. But more importantly, ladies and gentlemen, as I said before, I started off by telling you about my mother and father so you'll know what I really believe, which is that my credentials, some people would say it's the president of the Bar Association, like I said, highly recommended by the only person on either party, highly recommended by the Bar Association. But more importantly for me anyway, is the type of people we elect to the Superior Court. And I'll give you this. I run the primary, May 21st. I promised everybody in the Democratic Party I would go out and take the type of public service. Now, obviously, I don't have a typical Democratic background. I'm a military veteran, so I spoke to every American Legion post I could find. I spoke to every VFW post I could find. I had a law enforcement background. I've been endorsed by the Pennsylvania State Police, State Troopers, the corrections officer, traditional conservative Republican voters. They all endorsed me. I went and spoke to every law enforcement group I could speak to. I'm a shooter. I'm a gun owner. I'm a Second Amendment, proud Second Amendment supporter. I went to every shooting group I could find, every NRA group I could find, every country group I could find. And I told people this, and I said this to State Committee. And every single one of these organizations I went to, they all looked at me, you know what they said to me? Why are you a Democrat? And strange question, why are you a Democrat? And I got that question time and time and time again. People would say to me, Dan, Democratic Party, they're the party of the gays. They'd say to me, Dan, Democratic Party doesn't care about you. You're a straight white male. Democratic Party only cares about women. With Democratic Party only cares about minorities. I stop and I look at these people and I say, what do you do? And what's wrong with that? I mean, what's wrong with the fact that Democrats believe and understand that our allies in the LGBT community deserve to be treated with dignity and respect? And they deserve not to be discriminated against because of who they love. And if I'm elected to the Superior Court, I will defend those rights. And before we were the party of the LGBT rights, we were the party of women's rights. And I tell them, what's wrong with supporting women's rights? What's wrong with supporting the fact that we want our mothers, our sisters, our daughters, I've got two daughters of my own, to work in an environment where they're not subject to sexual harassment, where they get equal pay for equal work? And if I'm elected a judge in the Superior Court, I will defend those rights. And ladies and gentlemen, before that, we were the party of civil rights. Because as Dr. Martin Luther King said, Democrats believe and Democrats understand that our allies and our brothers and sisters in the African American community deserve to be judged on the content of their character and not the color of their skin. And if I'm elected judge on the Superior Court, I will defend those rights. But as I told people, I started off by telling everybody about my mom and dad. They came to this country with literally nothing. And they were able to retire in their 60s with dignity and pension because of the labor movement. Not just the labor movement, the union movement. And that's the core of the Democratic Party, ladies and gentlemen. We started off as a party of the working class because the working class in this country was built by unions. They gave my mother an opportunity, which is exactly what they were looking for. They gave my mother dignity, and they gave my father dignity and respect. At our core, we understand that workers' rights are the new rights. And if I'm elected to the Superior Court, I will defend those rights. So if you want to know who I am, if you want to know what I'm doing, if you want to know why I'm standing here right now, and why I'm in town, and that's who I am. I count on the fact that if I am elected to the Superior Court of Long Term Management in office, we will defend many rights. So I want to thank you for the opportunity to be here today. And I'm going to ask you to walk through your support of November 5th. Tell your family, tell your friends. I'm not a guy that's going to take a gun. I'm going to defend your right, my only gun, as much as I'm going to defend it. You won't have to do what I'll do as well. I'm going to cry and pray for you. So thank you very much.